So I know there's a few of you guys that were curious on carry distances for the normalized numbers off of GCQuad versus Connect. So I thought I would try to play a round and show you what they look like. So what I find is my wedges, the short irons, seem to be very close for a carry distance. Long irons are off the chart, hybrids off the chart. This normalized 230 on the quad, 260 on connect. Not bad. That one's about 10 yards out. Bit of it. Just a bit. Big hill there. That one was pretty close. 280 carry versus 282. I haven't really played a lot of rounds with the wind or lie penalties, so kind of new for me right now. Get on the green. Oh, I didn't hit it. I scooped right under that. Push. That was deserved. Turn a bit. Oh, I really hit that light thinking it was going to carry more than that. Well, that left us a lot of work. Right on the 5 foot mark. Good game. Well, that's a big discrepancy. I think find the hybrids. That was a 3 hybrid. I'm trying to pick the right club before I hit it. Obviously, I picked a 4 hybrid because 3's not in there. But that one had a big discrepancy, and I find hybrids and my 3, my 4 iron have the biggest differences between carry distance from the normalized number on quad versus E6 connect.
Didn't even hit it.
Not even close. Putt City now. I don't know why I couldn't get any one of those other ones to even come close. It was a 7 iron, so that wasn't too bad. 179 versus 181. Just tightened up a bit there. That tree. Oh no. That's gonna hurt. That was a wild pull with the driver. Stop. Oh, I needed that to stay there. Be a nice fade at the flag if it doesn't spin too much. Stop. Ooh. That right and didn't hit it. Wow. That was a mistake. Stop. It's good. Oh, it's miles too far. There's a 15-yard discrepancy on that gap wedge there from the normalized number. I had the wind helping. Tried to hit 120. I think I hit it 130. That was a mistake. Kind of making this a lot of hard work here. Oh no, I didn't hit it. I was right in the center of the cup. All right. Darn it. What a waste. That was a pushed right pitching wedge. One of those deals. Aim to the right side of the pin there, I might have been able to hold that one.
Yeah.
didn't read. This is not a normal thing with the quad disconnecting. Oh, the first three were good strikes. Shoot. Sit down. I don't know what happened there, a little disconnection. That just rolled right over the hole and didn't even make a noise, did it? I was walking that one in thinking it was dead center. That was a bit of a ripoff. Get in the bunker. That was just lazy. Shoot. Go, go. Thank you.
sloppy hole, wasn't it? It was really unfortunate. Up on that ball. Spin back. Whoa, I hit that one way too hard. For you guys that just saw that, I wasn't even anywhere near the ball, and it took a stroke for me. So naturally, the only time I'll ever use a mulligan is when that happens, and I don't know how that happened. Not getting any birdies. No birdies, just par round. A few good chances and that's about it. That was a chunky one. I was just trying to stay way away from that water so I didn't fall hook anything into the water. Just got it a little bit fat. Pull. Huge pull. Another one I forgot to hit. Jeez.
I was going to hit a big sweeping draw, and I just stabbed the toe into the mat. Now what? 82 yards. Jeez, that's disappointing. That branch. That was really, really, really silly. There goes my couple strokes there. Didn't need that on the 17th hole. Going that way, it's not going to come back. See, that's a big 7-iron. That's every now and then what frustrates me with the software. Just hit a 211-yard 7-iron. Got one back.